Hello and welcome everyone. In today's video, we'll be learning how to create this L-shaped bracket inside an X. Okay, so hang on and we are going to read the drawing, we are going to understand the drawing and we are going to create the entire design itself inside the software called an X. Now, if you are new to this particular channel, I would recommend you to kindly subscribe to the channel and also like the video if you find it interesting and find it helpful. Okay, please do like and share the videos which I create on a regular basis. So let us begin with, you know, creation of this particular part. Now, first of all, what we are going to do is we are going to start with a new file and we are going to define the location of that file. So, for example, here I'm going to save that particular file in this particular folder called NX product folder, and I'm going to name this particular file as L shaped bracket. So here I'm just typing L shaped bracket. Now you can follow the similar process if you want to create a similar, part inside SOLIDWORKS or inside Creo or inside CAD. Here you can do follow the similar process. The process is going to be very similar. Now only thing here is the thickness is not given in the diagram. So we are going to assume the thickness of this part as 0.5 mm or 1 mm. Now many people think like it's a sheet metal product and they are right. Yes, it's a sheet metal product, but we normally don't do sheet metal design in order to create this particular part. Okay. So we create different, or we are not going to simply use bending techniques, in order to get this particular part ready. We are going to use forming techniques. And whenever we use forming techniques, we use die and punch in order to create those particular shapes. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create this particular part of the exact same size or the exact same specifications. So here, as we can notice, the overall length of this particular part is 340 mm. Okay. And this is how the part is going to look from the top view. So let us first try to make the top view itself. So I'm clicking on sketch. I'm selecting the top plane and creating a new sketch. Now here using the profile command, I'm creating a L-shaped geometry like this. And believe me, the way I'm going to show you will be the easiest way, okay, of creating this particular part. Now here I have just created this particular shape, okay. Now once I get this particular shape ready, then what I need to do is I need to define some dimensions to it. So for example here, the length of this particular part is 85, the length of this particular part is 100. So first I'll define the two dimensions here. So I'll go to rapid dimension and length of this particular part is 85. Okay. And length of this particular part is 100. Then I'm going to define the overall length. The overall length, as we have noticed before, it was 340 and the overall height is 200. So I'm going to define the overall length as 340 and the overall height over here as 200. So once I'm defined with all the dimensions, I can click on finish. Otherwise, even if you want, you can even define fillets over here. But I would recommend you to define the fillets in the 3D environment because that will be easier. I'll click on finish and then I'll click on extrude and I want to take it downward technically. So I want to make the extrude go down, and here this particular value is totally imaginary. You can define any value you want to. I'm just defining a value of 30 or 40 or whatever value you want to. You can define it like that way. Okay. So here I'm creating an extrude of length 40. Okay, so if you wish, you can create an extrude of length 30, or because we are any which way is going to get rid of the extra material. Okay, so now what I am going to do next is, I am going to try creating a fillet. Now here I can notice there are 4 fillets on these 4 corners of radius 25. Okay, and here we have a fillet of radius 30 and 60. So let us try to create them. So here I will go click on edge blend command. I will choose single curve option, and here I will define the radius value of 25. Now first I will select the 4 corners which are having the same value. Then I'll click on the plus button to add a new set and then set a radius to 30. And here I'm going to select this edge, and then I'm again going to click on the plus button to add a new set, and I'm going to set the radius to 60 to select the last one. So there are total of 3 sets now, a set of radius 25, a set of radius 30 and a set of radius 60. Now once I click OK, you can see all the fillets are ready. Okay. Now the first step is completed, that is creating the fillets. Now what I'm going to do next is, I want to create this kind of a part. Okay, so I want to create this kind of a part. And what I wanted to do is, I wanted to create this part before the fillet was even completed. So what I can do, I can simply go before the fillet either by right clicking on the extrude feature and choosing make current feature. So here we have an option called make current feature. So if I select this option make current feature, it will automatically take me to that particular feature and I can now add some features just below it. Otherwise, you also in the tree, you have this particular control using which you can also change the current feature. The previous option was for older versions. Okay, so if you're using any older version, you can right click and choose make current feature. If you are not able to find that option, that means your feature is already a current feature. So now I'll click on sketch. I'll select this face. I'll click OK. Okay. Now here I have to create a trapezium kind of geometry. So I'm creating a simple geometry like this. Now in this simple geometry, I want this and this side to be equal to each other, so that it always remains a proper trapezium. Now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to see the measurements. For example, here the height is 20. This length is 70. So let's give those two measurements first. So here the height is 20. So here I'm defining the height of 20. The length is of 70. So I'm defining the length of 70. Then let's see other values. The angle is 140 and the distance from the side is 110. So now I'm defining the angle from here to here. The angle is 140 and the distance from the origin or from this side is 110. So I'm done with this particular part. I'll click on finish. And I'll click on extrude, and I'm going to extrude it back side. It should go on the other side. Okay. And it should get extruded until selected or until extended this particular face. And I'm going to use in Boolean unite option. So yeah, in extrude, I'm not defining a value. If you want, you can define a value of 100. Otherwise, you can choose until extended and then select unite and then click OK. So this is how the extrude is going to look like. Now, once my extrude is completed, then I'm going to create some fillets over here, and those fillets are of radius 30 and 40. Okay. So here I'm going to click on edge blend. Now here I'm going to set the radius to 30, then select the edges over here. So these two are of radius 30. Then I'm going to click on the plus sign here and then selecting the top two edges, which will be of radius 40. Okay. So here I've created a fillet of radius 30 and 40 respectively. Now here I'll click OK, and this is how the entire shape is going to look like. Now again, I can activate my blend, and this is how the entire part is going to look like. Okay, so you can do it step by step. You can do, take it slowly. It is not really a problem. Now, next thing is I need to create this part over here, which is technically a semicircular part of radius 10. Okay, and the length of that particular part is 245, and we assume that it's in the center of the geometry. Now to make this particular part, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a sketch on the top face. Okay, now you might feel what I'm doing is wrong. Okay, but just believe me, and here I'm creating a line. Okay, and from this point, I'm making it horizontally aligned. So we know the actual length of this particular part is 245. So I'm just defining the length as 245. And the distance from the side, okay, is 40, as you can see over here. So here I'm defining the distance from the side as 40. Now, once I'm done with that, I can click on finish, and you can see the line is ready. Okay, and I can simply go to curve and choose project curve. Okay, and in object to project to, I'm going to select tangent faces and select the top face. In the direction, I'm going to select the bottom direction. So once I click OK, this is how the projection is going to look like. And I can hide my previous sketch. Okay, so this easy it was to create this sketch. Now I can go to the tube command here. I have already created a detailed video on tube. Okay, so I can click on the tube command over here, which is in the surface tab in the more group. Okay, and here I'll set the outer diameter to 5. Okay, sorry, outer diameter to 20, I guess. Let us check. Yeah, outer diameter to 20. Then I'll select this particular curve, tangent curve. Boolean is set to unite, and I'll click OK. So now I'm getting this particular shape ready. Finally, I need to make some blends here. As we can see, there is a radius of 3 on the either side. So here I'm going to click on edge blend. And if you notice, I have a habit of first defining the radius and then selecting the edge, because that way I know radius of 40 is not possible, and for the software it will technically try to calculate that radius again and again if you try to provide 40 mm, for example here. So this is how long it's going to take, you know, if I define a wrong value. So why to waste unnecessary time? So what I can do is I can first set the radius value to 3 if I know that 40 or something which is very unrealistic for this model. Okay, so first I can set a realistic value and then select the geometry. That is what I normally do. Now here, I'm going to define one more fillet of radius 5 on this side. So here I'm going to choose tangent curve selection technique, and the radius will be 5 on the outer side. Now once this particular part is ready, simply what I need to do next is, I need to get rid of the excess material, okay, in order to create a complete geometry. If you have seen the previous video which was related to the plate design, you know what we are going to do next, okay. So I'm going to click on shell, and as we have discussed, we'll keep the thickness to 1 or 2 mm. Okay, or let's say 1.5 mm. And here I'm going to select tangent faces. First I'll make the bottom face open and then the side ones, and I'll click OK. And this is how this particular part is almost about to complete. okay, I can hide this sketch because I don't need that particular sketch. And now finally what I can do is I can make some holes here. Okay, to make the holes, I just need to add few circles here, like two circles here of diameter 20. So here I'll add a circle at the center of diameter 20 and one more circle over here of diameter 20. Okay, so I know it is not supposed to be tangent, but I'll just delete it in a while. And here also I want to make a similar circle of diameter 20. So I'll just add a circle here. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to make this and this point horizontally aligned. Okay, and then give certain values. For example, the distance between this center and this center is 25. So here I'm defining the value of 25. Not only that, I'm going to remove this tangent constraint because it was by mistake created. Okay, so this was not something which was intended to be done. Now I'll select the center point of this and this and make it coincide. So this center point and this center point, I'll make it coincide. And now all the circles are ready. Now I can click on finish. I can click on extrude. I can change the direction so that it goes down. I can choose subtract and I can click OK. So this is how this particular part is entirely completed. So I hope you followed along. Okay. And I hope you got this particular idea of, you know, creating this particular kind of model, because this is considered to be a difficult model to understand and also to create. Okay. Even after understanding. And as I told you, if you follow similar process, this model is creatable in any software if you wish to create. Okay, so thank you very much for watching. Have a great day ahead.